Good morning, student. I am Rose. Today we are in the third session of this chapter, that is Standard 7, History, Chapter 9, Development of Regional Cultures. So in the last two videos, we have learned about the different languages and different literatures, the different paintings which shows the development and changes happened in the medieval period. And this shows the regional cultures and customs of different lifestyles of the people of India. Okay, so today in this topic, we are going to learn about the music and dances which flourished during the medieval period. Okay, so first of all, let us see how the music became so much famous and how it affects the life of the people of India or various regions of India. Okay, so music was flourishing, also flourishing in medieval period, and main contribution of the music goes to both the bhakti and the sufi shades, because during the medieval period there was two important religions which came into force, that was the sufi saint and the sufi movements and the bhakti movements, because the saints of this movement shows a various devotion and love towards their own god, and they wrote so much poems and poetries, and even so much songs they wrote to praise their own gods or their songs or through which they can show the devotion towards their god. Okay, so this music mainly we can say contribution goes to both bhakti and the sufi saints, and it brought a so much influence in the in the medieval period. Okay, so under the influence of this Sufi music becomes so much important in the life of the court. Okay, so there were so many new forms of music and new forms of music instruments which was invented or which was being came into emerge during the medieval period. Okay, so you can say many new forms of music and instruments were developed during the medieval period. Among them, Amir Khusro was one of the most important person of the Alauddin Khilji, and he was one of the ministers of Alauddin Khilji. And we can say he was not only an expert poet or expert scholar, but also an expert musician. So, and he introduced so many Persian music or Arabic ragas, like you can say Amai, Ghura, and Sana. Okay, Sana in India. Okay, so these are the important Persian Arabic rags or melodies which was being introduced by the Amir Khusro. Okay, and he also invented or believed that some of the various musical instruments like sitar, then you have the tabla and the dholak. Okay, so when the music became a part of the king's court, so many rulers and the kings became a patrons of music, of different music. Even for example, Mughal ruler Akbar, there was a Tansen who even also introduced various melodies and ragas in different forms. Okay, so as I was talking about the Amir Khusro. Okay, so this Amir Khusro was not only a musician but also a inventor of various musical instruments. Okay, and even he is also originator of popular music style Qawwali Khayal. Okay, so he introduced this music, or we can say this popular musical style Qawwali, which was very famous in the 90s. Now we cannot hear it, but it was very famous in the 90s, and it was very beautiful to hear this kind of songs when you listen it. Okay, so and this music become a so much influence and so much ego, or we can say so much power to show the love expression towards any other people, different people, or towards the gods. Okay, so what happened? Mughal rulers encouraged music. Yes, Mughal rulers and other rulers like regional kingdoms of rulers also became encouraged the music in in their courts or in the administrative circles. Okay, and we can say among them in the Akbar's court there was a Tamsin. Okay, Tamsin of Gwalior. Okay, he created many. He also created many melodies and ragas during that time. Apart from Tamsin, there were various singers like you can say Baba Ramdas, Bechu Barwa, then Sur Das. Okay, these are the renowned musicians of that time of medieval period. Okay, and in the court of Shah Jahan and Jahangir, there was one more important musician who was called as the Abul Fazl. He plays a his Majesty pays most attention towards the music. Okay, so he was so much famous in music. Okay, so this music sometimes shows the cultures and traditions, even different expression, even different festivals. They used to sing, they used to express the happiness, they express sorrows, they express the gratitude with the music in the different administrative courts or different cultures during the festivals, during the different things. Okay, so this expressed the expression of heart which cannot be said with the mouth. Okay, so this is how they express, and this became one of the part of the human life. Till now we hear different kinds of music in modern world, but it also entertains us. So this is what influence, or this is how the music flourished in India during the medieval period. Next, we are going to talk about the dance form. Okay, so as the music dance has a very rich tradition in India, and we can say it has been this dance form is a medium of expression of emotion since the ancient time. Okay, so sometimes what happens with the words you cannot say to any person, but with the actions, with the expression, you can show your emotions, your expression towards other. Okay, so this dance forms was a medium of expression of emotions since the ancient time. From very ancient times, this dance became a expression of emotion since early ages. Okay, so and this we can say in India there are popular dances or different classical forms, different dance forms in India, which is very famous in India and it is known all over the world till now. Okay, so the most popular image of Lord Shiva in the form of Natra symbolizes the influence of the art form of the life of Indian people. Okay, so the Natra, which have you seen in the compass, you have seen the symbol of the Lord Shiva, how his dance forms it has been shown here. This symbolizes the how the art of life of the people, art of the life of Indian people shows that. Okay, so there are actually a six classical dance forms in India, which is very famous till now in all over India, and it has been practiced from a very ancient time. Okay, so which are they? Let us see. The Kathak, Kathak was famous in North India, that is originated in Uttar Pradesh. Then you have the Bharatnatyam, which is famous in Tamil Nadu. Kathakali, which is famous, which is the dance forms of Kerala. Odissi, it is the dance forms of Odisha. Kuchipudi, it is the dance forms of Andhra Pradesh. Manipuri, it is the dance forms of Manipur. Okay, so these are the important dance forms which were so much famous during the medieval period, and these dance forms are very famous, and we can say till now it has been followed. And these all dances shows different cultures, different tradition, different way of life in different parts of India from where this dance forms being originated. Okay, so let us see how the Kathak originated in the medieval period. Okay, so this Kathak is one of the important dance forms in the North India, and it is derived from the word Katha, which means a story, which means a story. Okay, so this actually this Kathak was not in a dance form, when it was not given any justice and music. Before that, this Kathak was used by a storyteller and storyteller in the temples of North India. Various North India, like Uttar Pradesh, and you have Madhya Pradesh, these are the areas where this Kathak used to cast a one type of a drama they used to show in the form of a katha. Okay, later on what happened, they started the gestures, they added the gestures and songs in the performance of the Kathak. Okay, so gestures means a different forms, a different styles to dance. Okay, gestures are the formation of hands or legs, how they use for during the music or during the dance form. Okay, so that is for the gestures and the song to the music afterward. Okay, and Kathak became increasingly based on stories of Radha Krishna. It became so much famous. Mainly in the North India, they used to show different dramas and they used to express in the form of a dance. Mainly the Radha Krishna, tale of Radha Krishna, then we have Ram and Sita's Kahani. Radha Krishna tale was so much famous, and it was this stories was enacted in folk play called the Ras Leela. Okay, this was enacted. Enacted means it was being performed in the folk play. Folk means in a traditional way called the Rasa Leela. Okay, Ras Leela. Okay, so this is how the Kathak was introduced, and we can say established a different gestures of how it became a very flow came to an Indian Kathak in India. Okay, so during the many Mughal rulers and other rulers even patronized the Kathak, and under the patronage many schools was being built. Okay, like we said, regional gharanas of Kathaks was being built, and some of the examples are that gharanas like Jaipur gharanas in Rajasthan, Banaras, and the Lucknow gharanas of Uttar Pradesh. So these are the important places where the especially the Kathak dance forms are being taught. Okay, so later in the part of 19th century, some changes underwent in which you can see emphasize complex and rapid footwork. That means so much rapid and complex footwork, which elaborate the customs, and we can say enactment of stories. Okay, so this is how the Kathak was developed in North India. Okay, that means first of all it was it was shown in a way of story, in a drama form they used to. So then after that, when in the 19th century, or we can say in the 16th and 15th to 16th century, some changes happened. That means some gestures and music was being given to the Kathak, and after that they started to give a different styles, and we can say the different styles in the stories, in the music, and they show the different dramas of different tales of the story of Radha Krishna or Ram Charit. Okay, so these kinds of dance formation or dance form was developed during the medieval period, and this shows the cultures. For example, Bharatanatyam, Tamil Nadu. Okay, so this dance form, Bharatanatyam dance form, was originated in Tamil Nadu. You can see when you see the dance forms of Bharatanatyam, you can see how it expresses, how it shows the cultures. That means cultures of Tamil Nadu. That means we can say how it wears and the music which is being in music in which it is being danced. Okay, then Odissi, Kathakali. You can see it is of the Kerala. You can see how it expresses the Kathakali people. We can say when they use this dance form. Okay, so these are the beautiful dance, Indian dance classical, which is famous in worldwide, and till now it is been forward. Okay, so I hope you have understood this topic. In the next topic, we'll discuss about the regional and other tradition, also the Rajput tradition of heroism. Okay, so go through the chapter, read it properly. Thank you for now.